Good morning, members of the faculty and delegates of CTBus 2021. My name is Dr. Shubhangi Gupta. I'm a second year radiology resident from Maharishi Markandeshwar Institute of Medical Sciences and Research, Haryana. Today, I'm going to present a paper on SMA angioplasty following a chronic mesenteric ischemia. Aim is to revascularize the occluded or severely stenosed superior mesenteric artery by stenting. Objective is to analyze the results and durability of angioplasty or stenting of the superior mesenteric artery. Beginning with the introduction, a 45-year-old male patient presented to the OPD with complaints of abdominal pain for 9 months, located at the epigastric region, radiating to the back, aggravated after intake of food. Increase in intensity of pain was seen for 10 days. He was on liquid diet at the time of admission and also gave a history of weight loss of over 20 kgs over a period of 9 months. No history of nausea, vomiting, or constipation. No history of fever was there. No significant past history was there. Personal history included presence of chronic smoking for 20 years and chronic alcoholism for the past 8 years. Because of the presence of clinical triad of postprandial abdominal pain, weight loss and food avoidance, possibility of mesenteric ischemia was raised. However, abdominal radiographs and ultrasonography was inconclusive, so a CECT abdomen and pelvis was decided on. CT abdominal angiography was done and it showed presence of occlusion of celiac artery and stenosis of hepatic and splenic arteries along with occlusion of the IMA. 90% stenosis of the SMA was seen. Multiple arterial collaterals were seen in the perihepatic, perigastric, and perirectal regions. This is a CT sagittal image showing presence of occlusion of the SMA at the ostium. Again, the coronal image showing presence of 90% occlusion of the SMA. Now, this is a CT sagittal image also showing presence of diffuse atherosclerotic changes in the abdominal aorta. Along with that, there is presence of occlusion of the SMA at the ostium. A 3D reconstructed image also shows presence of a stenotic segment at the origin of the SMA. Pre-procedural carotid Doppler was performed and bilateral carotid bulge and distal common carotid artery showed atherosclerotic plaques with ulceration. Now, predisposing factors for SMA occlusion includes history of heavy smoking, plaques at abdominal aorta and bilateral carotids. Management options include SMA angioplasty. So this patient was diagnosed with chronic mesenteric ischemia due to near total occlusion of the superior mesenteric artery due to accelerated atherosclerosis of the aortic walls. Now patient was administered antiplatelets and statins and he was planned for revascularization of the superior mesenteric artery. Material and methods required for the procedure includes guided catheters of different sizes, stereomo guide wires of different sizes, coronary balloons. Along with that, we also need a balloon expanding stent and pigtail catheters. So in this procedure, SMA stenosis was crossed with a guide wire. Angioplasty of the stenosis was done with the balloon catheters, which were negotiated with an expandable stent, which was inflated up to its nominal pressure of up to 6 atmospheres. So this is an abdominal angiography which was performed and the later view of the aortogram shows presence of 90% stenosis of the superior mesenteric artery at the ostium. Now this is an aortogram image showing a balloon expanding catheter in situ at the place of the SMA occlusion. After the inflation of the catheter, again an aortogram was performed and it shows a presence of expandable catheter at the SMA occlusus site. Now, post-procedural aortogram image shows presence of an adequate opening with normal opacification of the occluded SMA. This image shows a presence of diploid catheter. Post-procedural ultrasonography was performed, which shows presence of catheter in situ at the site of occluded SMA. Color flow Doppler shows presence of normal flow at the site of occlusion post-procedure and also shows normal waveform. Now, this is an axial CT and this is a coronal CT post-procedure which shows presence of stent at the site of occlusion of the SMA. Along with that, it also shows free flow of contrast post-procedure, which is indicative of normal flow in the SMA. Post-procedural 3D reconstruction image shows presence of catheter in situ at the site of SMA occlusion. So mesenteric ischemia is a rare disease with non-specific symptoms like abdominal pain, which is out of proportion to physical examination and has a high mortality rate. It occurs due to decreased blood supply to the splanchnic vasculature. It is usually seen in age groups between 50 to 60 years where significant stenosis of two or more arteries are involved. Chronic mesenteric ischemia is uncommon with incidence of up to 9 per 1 lakh people. Most common etiology is diffuse aortic atherosclerosis followed by stenosis of the proximal part of the celiac artery, the superior mesenteric artery, or the inferior mesenteric artery. Radiographs, they remain of limited value, being able to diagnose only late stages of the acute mesenteric ischemia when the bowel necrosis has already been present. Ultrasound abdomen with Doppler waveform analysis can depict proximal mesenteric thrombosis and secondary signs of bowel compromise, but it is limited for the diagnosis of distal occlusion and non-occlusive mesenteric ischemia and therefore is not recommended as the initial examination. CT angiography is emerging diagnostic test with high sensitivity and specificity and should be considered the first-line imaging modality. It also provides excellent anatomic mapping of the mesenteric vasculature, which is essential in the preoperative planning. Angiography is diagnostic as well as therapeutic. Management of mesenteric ischemia depends on bowel viability. If the bowel has undergone infarction followed by necrosis, then bowel resection by open laparotomy is done. And if the bowel viability is maintained, then revascularization procedures are considered. In case of thrombosis, thrombectomy is done, while in case of embolism, percutaneous transluminal balloon angioplasty with or without stenting gives a good outcome. So results in this particular case: stenosed area in the SMA was deployed with the stent and revascularization was achieved. Patient improved symptomatically and post-procedure CT aortogram was performed, which showed presence of satisfactory results. To conclude, angiography is the gold standard for occlusion or stenosis of the mesenteric arteries because we have an advantage of direct visualization of the mesenteric vasculature. Selective catheterization and pressure management measurements across stenosis areas can also be expertly evaluated. Following are the references for SMA angioplasty. Thank you very much.